So here's the interactive simulation that shows the change in the Gibbs free energy mixed two liquids, and the representation on the right is a cylinder that contains, in this case, one liquid, and the mole fraction corresponds to the value of the black dot. As I lower the temperature for these two liquids, let's lower it just a little further, notice we get to the point where we can draw a tangent line to the curve such that between the blue and the green dots, that tangent line has a lower Gibbs free energy than that predicted by our model that we're using to get our activity coefficients and therefore calculate the change in Gibbs free energy. And so that means we're going to have a more stable equilibrium condition when we have two phases present in equilibrium, as indicated by the figure on the right, and the mole fractions of these two phases are one corresponding to the blue dot and the green dot. If the temperature decreases further, it becomes even more noticeable. So now, very clearly, we have two distinct phases. And the relative amounts, if I change the overall mole fraction, then you can see if we get closer to mole fraction of the green dot, then we have more and more of the phase with the mole fraction of 0.76. So the lever rule can be used to determine how much we have at each phase along this tangent line, and lowering the temperature increases the excess Gibbs free energy. The liquids mix even less as we lower the temperature and we get more phase separation.